Hello everybody, this is aquafreely.art and we are the second video for the introduction of ZBrush changing 2.5D to 3D. So it's interesting that we have to do a video about this to just switch to the 2.5D to 3D because, and let's tap a little bit on the history of ZBrush. ZBrush originally was not intended to be a 3D sculpting software. Initially, when ZBrush was released in the year 99, and by the way, I might get some of the information wrong here, but initially it was meant to be a software that instead of using regular pixels, it used 3D pixels that actually has depth, and hence why the original company was called Pixologic, because they used this proprietary system called the PIXOL, which and that's P-I-X-O-L, which stands for depth with the pixel. So it's essentially 2.5 dimensions. And whenever you start ZBrush, it usually uses that mode. So it's a draw 2.5D mode. And it's usually the first wall that every artist usually encounters whenever they use ZBrush at first. For the first time, they go to this 2.5D modeling mode and they don't know what is going on. I sometimes wish they went straight to 3D to make it a little bit easier for anyone who's using ZBrush at first. But I will demonstrate. So say that you open ZBrush at first. And the first thing that you need to do, and just as a summary, we are going to not just cover how it changes as well from 3D to 2D, but we're also going to cover a little bit using T4Edit mode to change to that mode. We're going to learn how to introduce a primitive in here as well. And we're going to do a little bit of camera movement to be able to rotate, zoom in and zoom out. And then we'll finalize the video, because I want to make videos a bit shorter. But whenever you're painting first, and by the way, I highly recommend that you use a Wacom tablet whenever you're doing this. So if you don't have a Wacom tablet, it's not going to be the same. It's essentially like you're sculpting with a brick instead of a pen, because our pen usually has 1024 levels of pressure. Sometimes it can be 2048 levels of pressure, but the newer ones can be even more. And if you're using a click of the mouse, it's a binary input. It's like it is on or off. So you only have, okay, 0 to 100%. But with a pen, if you press very lightly, you can have very sensitive amount of pressure. So you can just press very lightly. Or if you press hard, you get a hard, like you get more amount of pressure or you get more intensity. But it can also work with the amount of how big a brush is too. So, the interesting thing is I've had a lot of students that they don't want to learn how to be able to use the tablet because they don't have the eye to screen recognition and they just don't like it. And they end up using the mouse and they get stuck to that. And that's really bad. So try to avoid, like try to get at it and keep using the pen, because if you're just using the mouse for this, it's not going to work. But at first, when you start, you're going to have this weird pixels kind of stuff. It's going to make no sense. So this is like, is usually the first barrier. So you're just essentially just painting pixels, right? And it's like, okay, why, what's happening here? Why are you doing this? And yeah, you can change the color and things like that, but you're essentially painting in 3D. And you can also add objects, like if you go here 3D sphere, then you're painting spheres, but it is not like what you want to do. Right, it's going to be very confusing. So what we want to do is clear the canvas. So you can always clear the canvas by pressing down Control and U. So this is what it does. It clears the canvas. And you also need to consider that the way that the viewport is seen in ZBrush is not a viewport. It is essentially like a Photoshop document kind of a thing that is able to also preview models in 3D. If for whatever reason, you've got a small preview, which I think by default you have a small window, we can change that very, very easily. If you go inside of here, inside of documents, you might have this button enabled by default. So take that off, because otherwise it gets annoying if you want to be specific. And here, this is where I usually like to have the settings. So say if, for example, you've got 400 times 200, and this is very tiny, you press on resize, which is down here. It's going to ask, are you sure? Yes. And now you're going to have a very small window. The problem with this is like, yeah, you whenever you do 3D modeling, you're only going to have a window that's very tiny. This is essentially like your render preview as well. This is like the size of your document, right? So in order, instead of doing that, what we're going to do is let's have something that's a little bit more comfortable. Consider that this is a 1920 times 1000 resolution. It is safe to say, all right, let's do 1800 times 1000. Press resize. It's going to ask you again, are you sure you want to do this? This is not undoable. Press yes. And now make sure that we got actual, so it's taking the whole space. And now this is going to use the whole space of the document. Now you still are painting in a 3D mode, like a 2.5D mode. So you're still not able to sculpt to do anything. So in order to change that, you have to go here and the tool palette on the right. Then you choose the primitive that you want to use. So you go down here where you've got this fella here, where it says tool. And let's start with a sphere, which is it's the most common primitive to start sculpting. So we click on this once. And then we drag a circle in the middle. It's, you can see it is colliding between like everything that you've got there, that's fine. But then once you let go and you let it go, right? You will see how as an icon up here, this have changed color. And now we are in draw mode. So draw mode is the 2.5D mode. But if you click on this one here, it becomes 3D. This is 3D mode. So if you click on this once, this is what's going to happen. It's the 2D stuff is still going to remain. So you then need to clear the canvas with Control N, which is essentially, it's a new document, but essentially what it's doing is just clearing the canvas, which is a very weird thing. So you just go Control N and then it clears the canvas. I'm going to do this one more time really quickly. So if you actually let it go outside of edit mode, it's going to go, it's a 3D mode. Do you want to do 2.5D? And then you go, oops, okay, sure, you switch. Now it's going to go back into that weird 2D mode again. And then you have to go like, oh, no, this is not what I want. You have to go click here. You are going to use a 3D mesh like this. You drag it. And then you press edit. And then after that, you clear the canvas with Control N. Yeah. This is going to take a few times to get into that mentality to like, especially if you use ZBrush once and then you get back to it 2 weeks later and then you get into this mode, you're like, what's happening? What the hell? So you drag a sphere or you drag an object first, then you go edit mode and then you start sculpting. So that's the first barrier. There is a second barrier. The second barrier is being able to do any sculpting whatsoever. So now that we are in edit mode, I'm going to show first how to do a little bit of rotation and the camera movement with the mouse. So if you move this anywhere like this and you go like that, it's kind of hard to tell. So I'm going to put wireframe mode so you can see the wireframe there. If you scroll, if you tap on the viewport or the canvas and you and you drag the mouse, it's going to do this. It's essentially going to rotate the object. And you can see that as well here with this fella here. It's essentially rotating. But if you want to zoom in, you can also use this to pan, to zoom, especially if you've got a tablet. It might be work a little bit better if you don't have the Alt button. But if you want to pan, and I'm going to activate this here. So if I press Alt, this is where you can drag, like just pan the object up and down. If you've got Alt pressed and you're clicking on the canvas. Now, when it comes to, say, if you want to like zoom in and zoom out, in order to do that, it's a little bit trickier. I think there is a different way of doing this, but I'm so used to doing it this way that I don't remember now what is this done. You know what? Actually, I'm going to look at it very quickly. Yeah, no, apparently I was wrong. There's not a second alternative to zoom in and zoom out. So the next way to zoom in and zoom out that I know of is to... First, you need to click on the viewport with Alt. So you click on it, and this is to pan. But then the trick is like you hold Alt and then you click on the viewport, which is the panning, but then you let go Alt. So your Alt is like not in use anymore. And this is how you zoom in and you zoom out. So it takes a little bit of getting used to. Like I recommend that you pause the computer and then just rotate a little bit, just get used to doing a little bit of panning, get a little bit of rotating. But then the next one that you should get used to is being able to hold down Alt, click on it, and then let Alt go, and then zoom in and zoom out, and do that a few times until you get used to it. Yeah. Anyways, carrying on. The next problem with this is being able to sculpt anything with ease. So if you want to start sculpting, you're going to get this error. And this is a very annoying error to enable sculpting. And this is why I'm forcing you guys to actually read it, because some people don't read things. They go, oh, there's an error, and then just don't even read. This is what happens a lot. To enable sculpting, please convert this to a 3D primitive to a polymesh 3D. So what's happening here is a 3D primitive is something that has got settings and options that you can customize. And you can essentially adjust the amount of vertices or how big it is or some of these settings. So this is usually inside of the tool palette. So what's happening is it is essentially locking you from editing the object unless you say, okay, cool, now I'm going to sculpt it. And if you ever want to change the settings, it's usually inside of here on initializer. This is where you can change it to make it bigger or smaller. I don't know why the canvas is done that. That's very interesting. So this is where you can go, okay, I'm going to make a fatter, smaller. I'm going to add more pixels or less pixels, right? So more or less subdivisions, stuff like that, right? And what's happening here is it's still in this initialize mode and it's not letting you change anything else unless you say, okay, I'm done with this. I'm ready to move on. And this is where then you press this make polymesh 3D button. So now this is the second barrier. So you press on that and now voila, you're able to sculpt on this object. So we're just going to do everything with a standard brush, but the functionality is if you, I got to change this color, make this white because that green was weird. And if you want to change the materials, I'm going to change the material here to something that's a little bit more neutral, like maybe this matcap here. All right, because I'm not a huge fan of that red color, so you're not going to see me often sculpting in that red. I feel like an amateur whenever I use that red for some reason. It's weird. But using the standard brush, the way that it works is you can press softly and then you can get these lines kind of a thing. Yeah. I'm going to remove the to the session of the master for a second. So now if you press, it goes up. But if I say that I want to do that a little bit stronger, I'm going to increase the size here, make it a little bit bigger. But you can also make the brush bigger by holding down the S button. So this is going to give you the size to say, okay, I want this to be bigger or be smaller. Yeah. But then let's say that I want this brush to be a little bit stronger. So this is where you can actually hold down the space bar. And you see, remember how you got that draw size? You've got it in here as well, while you hold down the space bar. But you can also do this with intensity. So you can say, okay, I want this to be very strong. And now that brush is going to be crazy intense. I recommend that you're careful with that, because then the pressure sensitivity doesn't behave very well. But you can also change that in here if you want. So you can go, okay, I'm going to have that where it was by default 25. And then you can sculpt that. Now, you might be noticing that I am going up and down, up and down. The way that you do that is by holding down Alt. So just to reset that. By the way, this is your undo chain kind of a thing. So you can go back and forward really easily like this as well. So I'm just going to go to restart that. The beginning, if you hold down Alt, it actually goes downwards. But then, if you do, and by the way, it's just giving me a notification to say, oh, there's 52 undos. Are you sure? But then, if I go over without pressing Alt, then it goes up. Yep, I don't want to go too much because it's 17 minutes this video, but let's stop it here. I think there's already a few things. So we have covered being able to change 2.5D to 3D. We have covered a little bit the history of ZBrush, came out in 99, and they had the technology of pixels, and that's why it starts in 2.5. We've also talked about changing to a polymesh 3D and why it starts using that initialized kind of prospects. And we have also covered how to clear the canvas and how to change the document size. For next, we're going to cover on how to increase the resolution of the mesh. And we're going to cover a couple of brushes that are quite important, such as the clay brush, the move brush as well, trim dynamic. But we might just cover 3 or 4 brushes. And then for the next video, we'll cover another 4 or 5 brushes. Okay, I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.